Common stock valuation is a key part of figuring out if a stock is a good investment for you. If a stock is overvalued and you buy it, you are likely to lose money. Buying undervalued stocks and holding them for a long run, though, can help you quickly increase your net worth. So let's take a look how we might do a valuation of stock like Microsoft. So I'm here at Microsoft's ticker page on seekingalpha.com. But what we see is Microsoft is currently trading for about $195 and the stock has a dividend of $2. Now to value Microsoft, we will need a little formula. The valuation on a common stock is the formula that you see here. Valuation is equal to expected dividend divided by required rate of return minus the growth rate. So what we need to know is the dividend for Microsoft, the growth rate for Microsoft, and the required rate of return for the Microsoft in order to get what Microsoft's value could be. Well, we already saw that last year's dividend was $2.04 for Microsoft. Now we need to determine Microsoft's growth rate. How could we do that? Well, one way to do that is to look at how fast the firm's sale is growing over time. So I'm going to return to the Seeking Alpha page to find that information. So if we click on financials, it will show me Microsoft's revenue. That is their total sales for 2019, which were $125.84 billion. And that grew from $110.36 billion in the previous year. This lets me go through and calculate the growth rate. Now, there are other metrics we could talk about using. You could look at profit growth rates or something similar. But this is a nice reasonable place. So I'm going to return to Excel and input these two numbers to calculate an estimate for Microsoft's growth. So we will put in for last year's revenue, $110.36 billion, and we will put in $125.84 billion for this year's revenue. Now notice, rather than typing out the full billion, I have simply left it an abbreviated form. So 110.36 to 125.84. And the growth rate formula I have put together down here in cell B8 simply looks at this year's revenue minus last year's revenue divided by last year's revenue, and estimates that growth rate to be 14.03%. Now finally, we need to know the required rate of return. Required rate of return is, in the essence, how much investors expect to own on Microsoft stock. In order to get you to invest in Microsoft stock, what kind of return would you need? 10%, 20%, 15%? Well, the number is going to vary from person to person, of course. But we might estimate what the market as a whole thinks. The average stock has a return of about 11% per year. Now Microsoft stock is a little bit riskier than the market. So maybe instead of 11%, we use 15.5%. If we do that, Microsoft's valuation is $157.90. Notice though, that the valuation is sensitive to the assumptions we have made about the expected dividend in the future, which is based on the growth rate, and last year's dividend, the growth rate assumption, and the required rate assumption. If we change this required rate return to be say 18%, well now Microsoft's only worth $58.5 per share. The point is that when you're doing the valuation, it seems very easy to just plug in these numbers, but you have to be very, very careful about the choices that you're making. If you spend time researching the company, you would really understand what the growth rates are likely to be, not just historically, what it's likely to be in the future. And so you have understanding of whether or not the firm is going to continue to grow its dividend, and the required rate of return is based on the riskiness of the firm. If you study these metrics about the company, you will be better prepared to evaluate what the appropriate figures are to input. Thanks.